This illustration is about sliding of a block on a surface having varying friction. Here we are given that a small block starts sliding down an inclined plane forming an angle alpha with the horizontal. And it is saying that the friction coefficient depends on the distance x covered by block as mu is equals to bx, where b is a constant. And in this illustration, we are required to find the total distance covered by block and its maximum speed during sliding. So here, if we draw the situation, this is say the incline with the angle of inclination alpha, and a block starts sliding from x equals to 0, and when it travels a distance x and reaches this position, we can say it is experiencing a friction in backward direction and the component of gravity in forward direction, which is mg sin alpha. And here the value of normal reaction would be mg cos alpha. So the value of friction here is mu n, and mu value depends on the value of x. So here we can write during sliding, acceleration of block is, here the block acceleration we can write as it is mg sin alpha minus mu mg cos alpha by m. So it will be g sin alpha minus mu g cos alpha, and the value of alpha we can substitute as bx. So this will be g sin alpha minus bx g cos alpha. And here as acceleration is a function of x, we can write a as v dv by dx is equals to g sin alpha minus bx g cos alpha. So it can be further written as v dv is g sin alpha minus bx g cos alpha dx. And we can integrate these terms on both sides. With that x equals to 0, the value of speed was 0. And we are required to find the total distance covered by the block. So after traveling some distance, when friction is increased to a high value, like here we are given mu is equals to bx. So when it increases to a high value, again the block will come to rest. So when again speed becomes 0 and the value of x changes to L. So here left hand side becomes 0 and right hand side it is, if we integrate it as g sin alpha multiplied by x on substituting limits it is L, minus this is bg cos alpha multiplied by integration of x is x square by 2. So if I substitute the limit, this is L square by 2. Here one L gets cancelled out, and you can see the value of L we are getting is this g also here we can cancel out, and this will be 2 tan alpha by b. This is the first result of the problem, the total distance covered by the block from rest to rest. We are also required to find the maximum speed during sliding. So we can see here as it slides, as value of x increases, the value of acceleration decreases. So when the value of acceleration is 0, the speed of block will be maximum, and then onward the speed decreases and finally it will come to rest. So here we can further write, we can continue over here with the same expression, v dv is equals to g sin alpha minus bg cos alpha multiplied by x and dx. So we integrate these terms from 0 to x and 0 to v. This will give us the speed of block as a function of x. So here the value we are getting is v square by 2 is equals to this gx sin alpha minus bg, integration of x will be x square by 2 cos alpha. So the value of speed we are getting is root of this 2gx sin alpha minus bg x square cos alpha. And we need to substitute the value of x in this expression where acceleration becomes 0. And here we can see a is equals to 0 when g sin alpha minus bx g cos alpha becomes 0. This I am taking from this equation. So here g gets cancelled out and the value of x I'm getting is 10 alpha by b. So at x equals to 10 alpha by b, the value of acceleration is becoming 0. So we can substitute the value of x over here to get the maximum speed. On substituting the value x is equals to 10 alpha by b, here this will become root of 2g, and this will become sine square alpha divided by b cos alpha minus bg. If we substitute the value of x square, this is 10 square alpha by b, so this will again be sine square alpha divided by b cos alpha. This b square cos square alpha, where square gets cancelled out with this. So on simplifying, we are getting this value is 2g sin square alpha by b cos alpha minus g sin square alpha by b cos alpha. So this will be root of g sin square alpha by b cos alpha. This is the final result of this problem.